The first step for roasting whole chickens is to season them and to properly place them on the Super Chicken Spike. When seasoning them, one of the problems that can come is if you have seasoning building up in chickens to where, or building up in spots on the chicken to where it can cause uneven coloration. So I always like to make sure when seasoning them that I'm rubbing them down to make sure of a proper distribution of the seasoning. Now keep in mind when you're selecting the coloration, when you're cooking the chicken, that depending on what you have in, on the seasoning, if there's sugar in the seasoning, a lot of paprika, things like that, that can obviously affect the coloration of the chicken. So you wanna be careful not to go too dark when you're making those selections. So I'll just make sure that we've got a nice even coating here. And then the next step will be to make sure that we properly spike the chicken. I like to hold the chicken up through its cavity here so that it's sitting up. And then I like to have the hooks on the spike facing away from me. So what I'll do there is I'll go ahead and I'll put the upright here inside of the cavity. And then I want to cross the legs on the crossbar here and then make sure that that bar goes inside of the chicken behind the keel. Then I'll take my chicken wings and I'll go ahead and I'll fold those back. So there you have a beautifully trussed chicken, no string needed. Okay, so we'll continue on here. You have a nice trussed chicken. Always making sure that I've got a nice even coating on the seasoning here. Giving them another rub before I put them on the spike. Go ahead and cross the legs. Make sure that your post goes behind the keel and inside the cavity. Fold the wings back. Now you have good, nice trussed chicken. Now that we have that ready, now we can go ahead and prep our self-cooking center. So in order to do that, we're gonna select the food that we're cooking. In this case, it's poultry. And we're gonna go to roasted chicken. Here it's gonna ask me a couple of questions. What coloration do you want? From light to dark, five different settings that you have here. Also, it's gonna say what sort of doneness are you looking for? Because we're gonna use the core temperature probe here. So I'm gonna go ahead and use our medium coloration just so that we can show the default setting there. And I'm actually gonna dial the chicken back just a little bit. 185 degrees is my specific number that I like to cook the whole chickens to. But at this point, the self-cooking center has no idea what size the chicken is. It doesn't know if it's a 2 3/4 pound chicken. It doesn't know if it's a 4 1/2 pound chicken. So it's just giving us an estimation here. Once we load the chicken and insert the core temperature probe, the self-cooking center is then gonna make all of those determinations and figure out how big is the chicken, is it cooking, and how much is it cooking at this one particular time. For this particular unit here, based on using the six bird spike, this is the self-cooking center 62, by using the six bird, we can actually cook 24 chickens in a batch in this particular unit. So you can see now that the self-cooking center is nearly preheated. So I'm gonna go ahead and pop the door. And now you'll see that the self-cooking center is asking me to load and insert the core temperature probe. If I go to my cockpit, you'll actually see it here as well on this page. So there you have the chicken with the probe going into it. Place my chicken right into the self-cooking center. And we're gonna go ahead and actually use a little drip pan here. Now, the placement of the probe here. The placement of the probe is when I'm cooking a full rack of chickens here, I always try and look for the largest one. There's usually a small variance when you're pulling chickens out of a case, could be 1/2 pound. I've seen much more than that as well. So I'm always trying to probe the largest chicken, making sure that that one's gonna get cooked, ensuring that all the other ones are cooked to a proper temperature. So I'm gonna go ahead and just insert the core temperature probe right into the breast of the chicken, okay? We don't need to fish that probe down the thigh of the chicken. That's very difficult to do. We put it right into the breast because it's the thickest part and it's the easiest, most repeatable way to properly probe the chicken. Remember that that probe is intelligent and it's reading in six different places. So as long as you have that chicken, the probe placed into the chicken into the thickest part, you should have no problem getting your chicken cooked. So now all I have to do is close the door and the self-cooking center is gonna take care of the rest. You can see here now that the self-cooking center is going to its ICC monitor and it's actually telling me that the probe position check is active. If we forgot to put the probe in and we put the chicken in and walked away, the self-cooking center would realize that, buzz at us and give us an indication that we need to come back and insert the probe. Or if we improperly placed the probe, if it did not like the position of it, it would give us an indication and ask us to come back. So you can see now on the cockpit, what's happening with the chicken is it's actually roasting in combination mode at 410 degrees with 90% humidity. But the fourth step is going to be combination mode, 343 degrees, 50% humidity. So it's actually slowing down the cooking process in the middle to make sure we have that juicy inside
The very last step is it goes into dry mode, 404 degrees, and is actually extracting humidity, allowing 50% of it to remain to crisp the chicken.
So you can see that the chicken is now done. We have zeros on the board here, or on the control panel, and the light is flashing to indicate that it's done. So I'm gonna pop the door. I'm gonna remove the core temperature probe, then I'm gonna place the probe back in its holster. First thing is I'll go ahead and I'll pull out our drip pan. And this will give me a nice place to land the chicken. Pull out my whole rack. And there we have six beautiful birds. So the chicken is now ready for packaging. It's ready for service or whatever your next step may be. There are two ways for despitting the chicken. That is, of course, to pull them off one by one. But if you may have many chickens that you have to deal with, there's also the method of giving it just a little flip here, a little shake, and off come your chickens. We'll let these rest just a second, and then we'll go ahead and we'll carve into them. But first, if you decide that's a beautiful chicken that you'd like to serve every single time, regardless of who's cooking, who's operating the self-cooking center that day, or how many you may be cooking, it's very easy to program the self-cooking center by saving those results. So simply, I'm gonna go and I'm gonna touch the notepad, and then I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna write roast chicken. And then I'll save that. So there we have roast chicken, always ready to go, whether it's a quarter chicken, half load, full load, two chickens, or 24, the self-cooking center will figure out the difference between the load and the size of the chicken to give you the same result every single time. So now we can go ahead and carve into that chicken to see how we're looking. Now the self-cooking center is buzzing at me right now, so all I have to do is simply hit the return key here, and it's gonna take that back a step. Nice crispy skin and juicy chicken.